I'll share my screen. Yes, great. I hope all of you can see my screen now. So, if I talk about the series of these webinars, which is called Unlearn with Transform, first of all, why called Unlearn? Because, you know, somewhere, if we talk about CA as a degree, we have been fed ever since we started CA that, you know, CA bante hi paise ki barish hone lag jayegi. Like, somewhere this notion is there that CA bante hi bohat, you can start earning right away and then you will be earning so well and you don't need anything else. But somewhere I feel, even after qualifying and looking at other professionals who are working, that, you know, the concept and the process of learning, it cannot stop with a degree. So to explore, and since there are so many CA pass outs, like going forward these days, the pass out percentage is kind of the highest since around like last 4 to 5 attempts. So there's a little imbalance between the demand and the supply. So how to make yourselves better, how to get an edge, this is what we are here to learn. And the notion of, you know, just one CA degree might not be enough somewhere. This concept we have to unlearn, and this is how this series actually took birth. Now, a lot of you said that you have joined me for the first time today. So I'll give you a brief introduction of who I am. Now, I am a chartered accountant myself. And I started my journey of mentoring around 3 to 4 months ago on LinkedIn. And I've also been taking few calls, counseling calls, mentoring calls via LinkedIn, via WhatsApp. I've talked to people on video. So this is how, you know, I came to be in touch with more than 50 to 60 professionals who I have, you know, counseled, and 300 students who reached out to me and are reaching out every day. Apart from that, if I talk about my professional experience, my work experience, I've worked in EY for 1.5 years. I also love speaking and, you know, presenting. So this is how I've kind of turned it into being a motivational speaker and a presenter. I create content on LinkedIn on a daily basis. I love writing, and this is how I, you know, I'm also blog, and I'm also a storyteller on LinkedIn and on Instagram. So yes, this is a little bit about me. Coming to the next part of it, the main questions. Now, should I continue to study after CA? If yes, which course should I go for? How much cost, time and effort will it require? Every course will entail. And can I continue this course while working in a job? That is very important to answer. So these are the basic questions we will be looking at. Like I mentioned in the beginning, we have already covered ACCA, CPA and CFA and a few different certificate courses given by ICAI and other institutes. And today we'll be taking talking about MBA as a degree. In continuation to today's webinar, we have a very special webinar coming up tomorrow as well. It is for people who are looking for, you know, some kind of alternatives to MBA. And we have a very special speaker who will be associated with us. I think Dhaval is here with us. I'll ask him to introduce himself later on to all of you. Now, yes. Coming to the series, today and tomorrow will be primarily be focused on MBA and alternatives to MBA. Now, before we go into how to pursue a degree, let's first venture into whys. The why is the most important aspect you should analyze if you're thinking of going for further education. Now, try answering these questions for yourself. Are you going for a course because you want to do it, and not under someone else's influence or peer pressure? Are you going for a course because you want it and not because it is fancy or it sounds fancy or it promises lucrative opportunities? That should not be why you are driven for it. is the course that you've opted for commensurate? I'll just close this for all the noise. Yeah. Is the course that you have opted for commensurate with your long-term goals? So, do you see as yourself as a core finance professional 5 years or 10 years down the line? And whatever course you are trying to opt for, is it commensurate with your long-term goals? Or are you someone who just wants to keep learning no matter how difficult it can get? Now, if you can answer even one of these questions with a yes, then you might want to take up a course, right? Then apart from these reasons, other reasons could be as simple as, you know, you want a qualification for a desirable work profile that you are targeting at your office. You want to keep learning and growing professionally, but you just don't know how to do it. Then coming to courses like that offer core finance opportunities, you have a knack for some kind of course. It could be stock markets, it could be engaging with clients, it could be consultancy. And apart from that, it could be as simple as that you want to grow internationally. You just don't want to stay in India. You want to go somewhere outside and you want to continue working there. These could be the reasons that you might decide to take up another course after your CA. And yes, these are good enough reasons. Now, coming to the core topic for today that we have, which is called MBA. I have seen so many professionals struggle with this question within themselves that, you know, MBA is such an expensive course. It's such a time-taking course. I'll have to first invest time into studying it. Then I'll have to spend 2 years into going for it. It's a full-time course. I won't be working at that time. I might have to raise a huge education loan to go for it. Is it all worth it? Now, before going for this question, that is it all worth it, let's first ask ourselves, what are the reasons that we are trying to go for MBA? All right, let's decode it slide by slide. Right here, right now, first, let's unlearn. What do I mean by unlearn? Now, MBA, plus there are certain myths that we've been fed since childhood, saying that, you know, MBA's ki presentation skills achhi hoti hai, CA's ki technical skills achhi hoti hai, but MBA's ke paas technical skills nahi hoti aur CA's ke paas presentation skills nahi hoti. Now, if you see on the left side of your screen, these are facts. And if you see on the right side of your screen, these are myths. All right. Somewhere we've been made to believe that MBAs are smaller personalities than CA. Now, I want to ask you first, kis college ke pass out MBA se compare kiya hai? Was it an MBA graduate who was graduating from a top institute like an IIM, some IIM, tier 1 institute, any institute for that matter? Or was it some Nukkad college? Like Nukkad college se mera matlab hai any second tier or third tier college, which is, you know, there everywhere and which does not give you global recognition. Now, obviously, if you compare yourselves with an IIM graduate, somewhere you will realize what I'm trying to say, that no, it's not true that MBAs do not have technical skills. They will have technical skills also, and they will have presentation skills also, and you won't be able to counter them. Because if you see the quality of chartered accountants passing out today, I'm not sure whether to say, do they even have technical skills as such, you know? Now, don't take this in offense, but you know, you have met these people, right? Who are chartered accountants, but who don't know basic things. In an interview or, you know, in group discussions, they are not able to speak. So, if you compare yourselves to IIM graduates or graduates from top colleges for that matter, why can't I hear anybody else? I'll just mute everyone.
Because everyone is mute.
Yes, Mukul, can you please mute everyone if they are unmuted? Is everyone able to hear clearly now?
Yeah, it's clear.
Is everyone able to hear clearly now?
Going fine now. Continue.
Yes.
I think there was a little issue there and it has been solved. Okay. Yes. Continuing, now if I talk about top tier institute pass outs, MBA pass outs, they have all the skills that any job, you know, will require. All right. Because if you see, MBA is a 2-year rigorous, you can say, college process, which entails you to go to college every day at early morning times or whatever timings. You need to give presentations without even being given any notice. You need to interact with the students. You need to participate in team building activities. You need to interact with faculties. You need to interact with everyone else. You'll be just called at like 1 hour notice that, okay, abhi our presentation, though it could be 3 a.m. in the night. Yes, this is what happens in IIMs at times. So you cannot undermine what these people are going through in their college, no matter what. So I took this up yesterday also, and I'm saying this again, that no matter how much you compare a full-time college education with a professional degree like a CA or CFA or any other course, which is a professional course, people skills, if you talk about people skills, that a college student will be having more than a person who's taken a professional course, save some exceptions. All right. So I just wanted to bust these myths. Now let's come to the left side of the screen and see that, okay, MBA plus CA can be a great combination for you. Now, don't compare yourself to Nukkad MBAs. Compare yourself with IIM level MBAs and then make a judgment where you stand. Now, if you are willing to go for MBA, you always have to aim for the top 10 institutes which are globally recognized. And repeat with me, say no to correspondence. Repeat with me again, say no to correspondence. Why? Because correspondence courses or part-time courses, they are doing no good to you. You are paying the fees, you are submitting assignments, you are probably taking the exams. But if I talk about skills, where are the skills that you built in that education? It's not about getting a degree, or it's not about studying and getting, you know, briefly some knowledge out of it. It's about building those skills that you need to function in the real world, you can say, economy. In a job or in practice, or if you decide to set up a business, anywhere, you will need those skills. That is important for you to build, and that will only happen if you spend time there. Coming to, yes. Now, how to decide whether to go for an MBA or not? We will definitely cover them, these points in the future slides. Now, what should drive you? When will MBA work, or, you know, where will it get you? The things that should drive you should be, if you are someone who, so many chartered accountants I've heard these days, they are not happy with their jobs, or they are not happy with the how, you know, they are being treated at their jobs. They do not like the work that they are doing. So if you are thinking somewhere that, okay, I do not wish to go for these kind of roles throughout my life or throughout my career, because somewhere, yes, I'm specializing in these profiles. And now I want to start, abhi CA kar liya, okay, I have had some work experience. Now I want to start my career afresh. Now I want to explore a field that I have always wanted to. It could be anything. Or, you know, now talking about the byproducts that will accrue when you take these decisions, but these should not be your driving force. All right. Now, of course, one thing could be, the byproduct would be figuring out what you want to do in life. So say you have already realized that somewhere you don't like working in a CA oriented job, and now you're wanting to start your career afresh. So this will be the byproduct that, okay, now I'll be able to figure out what to do with my life in the next 1 year or next 2 years that I spend in an MBA, and that will help me set up the course for the rest of my life. Now, second reason, to get access to avenues and profiles which are generally not outlined for chartered accountants. Now, yes, I have met CAs who love their jobs, who love getting into consultancy, and who love interacting with their clients, who love practicing or who love being in their jobs, the CAs who are in like really good elite roles, they like their jobs. So it's good for them. But if you are someone who has recognized that, okay, this is not something that I want to do and I want to have access to newer avenues, it could also be a reason for you to explore the option of MBA. Or to experience the realistic struggles that a campus life will give you. Like I mentioned before, that MBA college education will come with so many challenges, with so many, you know, real life experiences that you will get at campus. It cannot be compared with a distance learning or a professional course that you sit at home studying and give the exams. So yes, if you want to experience that, the byproducts would be experiencing a college life, or you know, you could be a pro at multitasking, you will be able to develop management skills, and these are the things that will just constantly accrue to you. Now, another reason could be to get out of your comfort zone. Okay, so I am an individual who loves doing new things, and right now, okay, I've spent 2, 3, 4, 5 years in a job, but I don't know what to do now. I'm too much of in a comfort zone. I'm earning very well, but I don't know if I want to continue here. I'm not sure. I just want to get out of my comfort zone and try something new. Okay, good enough reason. You could still opt for it. It can also help you get a good brand name on your CV, which is extremely important. Yes, all of us can admit it. And of course, like I told you, to develop management skills. If you are someone who's very shy, who's very introverted, who hesitates at talking to people, or you know, who kind of develops cold feet if any stranger comes to talk to you, then might be a phase in your life, you know, somewhere we are all missing opportunities when we are not talking to people or when we are not giving enough time in networking. Somewhere we are missing opportunities. Then why not go for something that will challenge your personality, that will make you develop into an individual that can be more outgoing or, you know, better at seizing opportunities. These could also be your reasons if you want to develop your people skills, your networking skills, your social skills. If you really want to challenge yourself and get out of your comfort zone, if you want to participate in activities that challenge you as a person. So say that I call you, any one of you, right now to speak in front of everyone else. Would you be able to do it? Can you answer that? So if the answer is no, then don't you want to improve on that skill? This could also be, you know, a factor driving you. Now, this factor does not necessarily drive everybody. Some people are really happy where they are, and I really respect it. Some people are actually happy thinking that, okay, now I'm earning well and I finally have a direction in my life and I want to proceed in this direction. That's amazing. I mean, there could be nothing better than that. If you are at that point, I really respect you and you should stick to your decision. But if you're constantly feeling some kind of itching and you are like, okay, kuch naya karna hai, then you might go for it. All right. Whoever you are as a person, you get to decide that, okay, what you really want to do. So there's no shame in admitting it. If you're happy being, you know, more of an introverted person, great. I respect it. Now, of course, like I mentioned, the byproducts would be getting a good brand name on your CV and also to significantly expand your CTC. Yes, it is true. Top tier institute pass outs who are coming out of those institutes do get a very good CTC, and there's no second thoughts about that. But if you think that, you know, a normal college or a part-time MBA course would fetch you a lot of hike in your CTC, then that is not necessarily true. All right. Now, people who are very active on chat, great that you are answering each other's questions. But if you don't focus here right now, you might miss some part and you might come for your queries even later on. But these parts will not be repeated. So I'll just request you to not ask any queries right now in the chat. I'm not looking at what questions are coming in. I'm just focusing on the presentation and I'll suggest you also do that. Yes. Yes, it's a tough decision, both on the brain as well as on your pockets. That is why here's what you should do before you make that decision. Now, like I mentioned it to you, answer the why. The why is very, very important, and it's more important than the how. The how will be figured out if you figure out the why. Now, to determine this why, I have devised a series of six questions, or you know, a six-step methodology that you can write for yourself and figure out that, okay, now these questions, if I answer, I'll be able to determine that whether I want to go for an MBA or not. The first one would be, try and find out what would be your subject of specialization. And yes, a lot of people have this notion that abhi CA ban gaye to finance mein specialization karna hai. That is not true. That is not necessary. I mean, if you really love finance, you should go for it. But if you are not someone who loves finance, and it can happen, it's not impossible, you could go for some offbeat subjects. And a few subjects we'll be discussing in the next slide, so we'll come to that. But yes, it could be anything, whatever moves you, whatever motivates you, it could be anything. Second step, list out colleges course wise or territory wise in order of priority. Now, when I say territory wise, it could be in India, it could be in abroad. Whatever your goals are, whatever your future aspirations are, wherever you see yourself in the future, you can list that down. So say that you've always wanted to live in Europe. Okay, maybe not anymore, but okay, say you've always wanted to live in Canada. So say you make a list of top 10 colleges, MBA colleges in Canada. But before that, you'll have to see what subject you're looking for, and according to that, you have to make your list, right? Now, the third step is to connect to alumni on LinkedIn or Facebook. This is very important, because if you are willing to reach somewhere, if you are willing to get at any place, you first need to assess how it will feel to be there. So it's better to talk to people about their experiences and was it worth for them or not. So say if I wanted to go to IIM Ahmedabad, I reach to certain people through LinkedIn who have been to IIM Ahmedabad, and I talk to them, okay, how was the MBA experience for you? You know, of course, this is not happening directly. You cannot just go and shoot these questions in their inboxes. You will first have to build a rapport with them, have a conversation with them about how they are doing, about how you are doing. And, you know, you can maybe try and ask them that, okay, can we talk on a call? I had certain doubts in my mind. I was skeptical about this course, and I just thought you might be able to help me out because you've been there. Now, people welcome helping. Okay, so most of the people who are on LinkedIn, they are very open to discussions, very open to conversations. So if you are messaging 10 people, one or two might turn you off, but six to seven people will take your requests. So don't be shy in doing that. Try and build a rapport first and then go and try talking to them. That would be helpful to you. And then you can ask them, okay, how your experience was. Whatever your concerns are, how much cost there was, or you know, how much time you had to give in, how much pressure there was. These are the kind of questions you might need an answer to, and these are the best people who can help you out with, because they've already been through that. Now, fourth step would be, find out when and how to apply to these colleges and what all is needed to apply. So if it is in India, of course, you'll have to give CAT. And your score in CAT will determine on how you get to which college you get in. And if you're aiming top 10 institutes, boy, your preparation must be rigorous. I mean, बहुत आसान है बोलना कि यार 10 इंस्टीट्यूट्स में जाना है टॉप के, पर उसके लिए पढ़ाई करना, इट्स अ डिफरेंट बॉल गेम ऑल टुगेदर. एंड आई रियली मीन इट व्हेन आई से इट, यू विल हैव टू गिव एवरीथिंग दैट यू हैव टू इट. जैसे सीए फाइनल के लिए पढ़ाई करी थी ना, वैसे ही जान इसमें लगानी पड़ेगी. एंड डोंट हेजिटेट ऑन डूइंग दैट, बिकॉज इफ यू कैन गेट देयर, इट्स इट विल बी अ बिग डील फॉर यू. ऑल राइट. Now, if you are willing to go abroad for an MBA, and if you have certain destinations in mind, of course, there are a few exams, GMAT, TOEFL, IELTS, SATs. So these are the exams you generally give, but of course, depending on where you are wanting to go, they might have a different list of requirements, and you would have to figure that out. And plenty of stuff available on Google and YouTube, plenty of videos available, so don't hesitate in researching. I know people love being spoon-fed, but this is something that you'll have to do for yourself. All right. Coming to the fifth step, find out what all exams you need to give and how much you need to score. Right? I've already covered this. Then sixth, devise a method and routine to prepare for those exams in the most economical way. Now, when I say economical way, some people like the coaching method. But personally, if I talk about myself, the coaching does not work really well with me. So I would more, prefer into self-studying. I would use all the free resources that are available on YouTube, on different websites. And there are so many people who are, putting out free educational material everywhere. So accessing them and preparing in the most economical way you can, not spending a bomb on coachings. That would, I think, be my preferred way of going for it. And might be yours too. So these are the six questions. I want you to screenshot this slide and I want you to write the answers to these down in your diary or your journal or your notebook. And this will help you figure out whether to go for it or and like how to go for it. This is basically focusing on the how. Now, second point on the left side, if you see, do proper and lots of research. I've already covered how you can do that in the six questions. And third point that I want to mention is don't pursue MBA without work experience. Why this is so important is that as a fresher, as someone who's just qualified CA final, you know nothing about how working in a corporate works, or working in a practice works, on how to talk to clients. Of course, you've had your share of articleship, but that's not enough, I feel, especially if you are from smaller towns. I'm from Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, and I was from a smaller town, and I can vouch and give it to you that my articleship experience was nothing compared to my Big Four experience. So if I talk about work experience, why it is so important? Because the kind of routine or the educational structure that you will be circled within an MBA college, that will require you to have certain knowledge and certain experience. It will require you to have a certain working background. And also, people will be looking out for what area you've worked in and for what area you're targeting. So the kind of discussions, if they're having a discussion about how to build a certain business. All right. Now, if you haven't looked at businesses or if you haven't worked in that kind of environment, you don't know anything about businesses, how will you go forward with that? So it becomes very important that you have at least 1 or 2 or 3 years, even 5 years of work experience. It is your choice. I mean, it's absolutely your choice, but some work experience, minimum 1.5, 2 years is a must for you before you go for an MBA. All right. Now, coming to the next slide. Yes. Now, what are the options to choose from? Which MBA specialization would be best for you? It could be, there are so many subjects available, but I have picked here the subjects that are most relevant to us being professionals from this field and the kind of options that we would like to have. So it could be, of course, finance is one option. Operations and international business, people who are very business oriented, have an entrepreneurial mindset. They would like to go for something called international business. There is operations management. If you want to be at the helm of the business and manage everything, there's operations management. Then yes, people who like, networking, talking to people, they have people skills, they have good communication skills, or they want to build these skills in themselves, they might want to go for a very offbeat field, which is marketing. Yes, I mean, if you're smiling to yourself right now, yes, people do that. It's an option for you. Because, after chartered accountancy, if you want an offbeat field, marketing is a great option and so much in trend these days. Digital marketing is coming up with huge opportunities. Then, of course, HR is also an option. Now, why people go for HR? Because I've seen people, like employees who were recruited as HRs in top companies like, you know, MNCs, FMCG companies, Cipla, Reliance, and Nestle, Cadbury. So these kind of companies, if you join them as an HR, you have very sorted lives. I mean, so many of us have been struggling from, you know, not getting work-life balance. We have to work so much, itna stress hai, blah, blah, blah. Lekin, there is a way out, okay? So HR is a department, if you are very outgoing, if you like interacting with people, if you want a sorted life and work-life balance, then HR might be a possibility for you. All right, coming to, yes, so business analytics, if I talk about business analytics, is again a very hugely growing field these days. So many jobs coming up in this area, and you know, the kind of business or you know, the kind of economy that is being headed to at this point of time, this is going to be a, you know, huge employing area in the future. So again, this might be an option too. Now I've broken down, you know, MBA in finance, MBA in marketing, and MBA in business analytics into the kind of jobs that you get if you get into these fields. I will quickly run you through this. So MBA in finance, yes, you might land up in asset management, corporate finance, corporate banking, credit risk management, treasury, private equity, hedge fund management, derivative structuring. These are the kind of things that you will, you know, mostly land in. Now, I will cover the part where I talked about CFA versus MBA yesterday here. Now, of course, if you attended my yesterday's webinar, you know that I talked about how CFA is still a professional course and why it should not be equated with an MBA in finance, right? It is important that you give the credit to MBA where it is required. It is very important. So don't compare the kind of pay and position MBA will get you to the kind of pay and position that CFA will get you, because ultimately, CFA is a professional course. It's not a full-time, you can say, somewhere that you have to be physically present course. So, of course, it's not equivalent to MBA in finance. So, whenever you're passing out of top-tier institutes, you're already a chartered accountant. And if you do MBA in finance, top companies will hire you. Your pay will go up to like 40, 50, 60 lakhs. I've seen people who... You know, if I am Kolkata recently, like a friend of my friend, he was a chartered accountant. He did MBA in finance and he also did like a couple of levels of CFA, and he got out of that institute with a whopping package of 70 lakhs. I mean, can you believe it? That wouldn't have been possible if he was just a CA and a CFA. Of course, because the skills a full-time college education can teach you, no other course can. That is absolutely true. So don't compare these two. CFA is an amazing course in terms of knowledge. You will learn so much in it. It has everything to offer to you if you have interest in core finance, if you want to learn about markets, economics, finance. I mean, these things, if you really have a passionate interest in, yes, you should go for CFA definitely, because it is very enriching in terms of knowledge. But like a CA fresher ends up having a package of around 10 lakhs in the beginning of their career, 8 to 10 lakhs is the average. Just like that, like after CFA level 3 as a CFA fresher, you would be expected to have a package of somewhat like 8 to 10 lakhs and not more than that. So if you're going for CFA thinking that, okay, ab mera package bar jayega, ab maine CFA kar liya, I have an additional degree, so I can go for an offbeat profile, or I can expect a 10 lakhs increase in my package, that is not going to happen. Not now, not in the future. So don't like keep unnecessary futile expectations because of these degrees, right? So yes, this was a quick comparison. Now coming to MBA in marketing, like I talked, marketing could be a great opportunity for someone who's wanting to restart their career and who's already either good at networking skills, or they want to be good at networking skills, or they want you know, a career totally different from some CA profile. You could end up being you know. So digital marketing is actually a very hot profile these days. you could be into digital marketing, you could be into managing, product manager, media planner, branding consultant, storytelling. People on LinkedIn are doing so much storytelling these days. You could be a strategist, consultant, corporate sales manager, market research analyst, sales manager, media planner. Even you could go into some offbeat profile like event managing, even that is a thing. So yes, these are the kind of profiles that you will get. Now, I'm not saying the stress will be less here, because these guys have their own share of problems in their life. I mean, these guys have different targets to meet. It's more of a target-driven career. So, of course, you have to make your decision very well informed before you opt for something like this. But yes, if you are someone gets satisfied with the monotonous jobs and who wants to do something new every day, then this might be a thing for you. Coming to business analytics, now data analytics is a very hot profile these days. Marketing, risk, customer, supply chain, human resource, web analytics. These people mostly deal with huge, humongous data, filtering that data, squeezing that data, you know, just making that data available for the right consumers, right clients. So this is more of a data trading kind of a thing, and so analytics is mostly about that. Coming to where will you land in human resources, popular business analytics, and again, I've covered almost same things here. I'll just cover human resources again. Talent management, employee well-being, training and development, events, awards, recognitions, employee communication. These are more like, you know, more of a work-life balanced profile. So even you could go for something like that. I mean, especially the girls who are trying to target a career which is a little, you know, less hectic, less stressful. If you have to spend lesser hours in office, then this could be something that you want to go for. Now, you know, let's address the elephant in the room. The cost involved with respect to India, abroad, and the cost-benefit analysis of it. Now, in India, if you talk about top 11 institutes that I've covered here, they are both government and private institutes. The fees has gone, like, if you talk about IMA, it could go up to 23 lakhs, all right? And I think this is, what, 2019 data, okay. So, 23 lakhs. 21 lakhs and JBIMS or IIFT Delhi or IIM Indore, these have comparatively lesser fees, but they are good enough colleges again. 16 lakhs, 15 to 16 lakhs, the fees can go. So yes, you could go for these institutes. These are the top-notch institutes. You can take a screenshot of this slide to have a brief idea of what kind of fees they demand. Now, talking about how to manage the huge fees. See, I want you to understand that if you clear, first of all, you need to clear CAT with a very good percentile, right? You need to have a very, so there's something called points. You accumulate points when you have certain quotas associated with you, right? So yes, now, if you talk about how to manage the fees, you are already a chartered accountant. You have some kind of work experience. If you are willing to go for a college, then, you know, they know that you are aiming for such a top tier institute. You will come out with a huge, great package. And जब आप कैट से उतना परसेंटाइल लेके निकलते हो और आप ये अश्योरिटी से निकलते हो ना कि आप ऐसे इंस्टीट्यूट में जा रहे हो, तो बैंक्स लाइन लगाती है आपको लोन देने के लिए. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाई आई थिंक यू शुड ऑप्ट फॉर अ लोन इज बिकॉज इवन इफ यू आर दैट रिच और इफ इवन इफ यू कैन अफोर्ड दिस काइंड ऑफ एजुकेशन, इट्स गुड. बट आई स्टिल बिलीव इवन इफ आई कुड डू दैट, आई वुड नॉट माई पेरेंट्स टू यू नो बियर दैट काइंड ऑफ कॉस्ट फॉर मी. सो इन एनी ऑफ दैट केस, going for a loan is a great option, because you'll be the kind of package that you will get after you qualify from these institutes, you'll be able to repay that loan in a couple of years. So that won't be a very big headache for you in a very long term. And up to 20 lakhs collateral for these kind of institutes, it's easily available without any collateral. And EMI usually starts post course completion. So yes, you might just decide to go for something like that. And don't worry about repayment or don't worry about the interest rates. Don't worry कि banks loan देंगे या नहीं. आप CA हो already. मैं वापस बोल रही हूँ, अगर आप इस type के institute से MBA करके निकलोगे, आपका package अच्छा रहेगा, banks line में लगेंगे loan देने के लिए, right? Coming to the next slide, IIM Bangalore, yes. So, I've just taken a little analysis of one institute here. This is an analysis of IIM Bangalore packages that they gave to their students. Total number of participating students, if you see, were 409 on the top. And total number of companies were 129. If you see what kind of pre-placement offers were made, lateral placement offers were made, overseas offers were made, the average CTC was around 25 lakhs. Right, per annum, and the overseas average CTC went up to 62 lakhs. So, yes, I mean, there is a certain kind of surety attached with the name of these institutes that, okay, you won't be disappointed with a package that is not at par with your expectations. So, yes, even if you get a loan, you'll be easily able to repay it. Don't be worried about that. Rest assured. Coming to, yes, so IIM, the return on investment, the business school on the left, the average salary in 2009 and the fees. In most of the cases, if you see, the average salary is obviously greater than the kind of fees that they charged. So again, repeating the same point that up to 20 lakhs loan is available without any collateral. So, bindas okay, lena loan agar aap aise kisi institute mein admit ho jate ho. Pehla step to definitely CAT clear karke utna percentile lana hai, right? So, once you reach there, then you decide on, you know, whether to go for it or not. So, I'm just saying that be bindas and go for it. It will be worth it. Now, coming to abroad, top destinations for MBA abroad, and rating has been given by their alumni, right? So, US is one of the hot destinations. So, I'm talking about this keeping in mind, not really taking the current scenario in mind, because right now nobody would want to go to US or Europe, and it's not even allowed. So, yes, don't really get into that right now. US, UK, Canada, Australia, Germany, France. So these are the top 10 destinations that we usually people prefer. Coming to the cost involved that there is if you go for education at these colleges, top tier colleges in these countries. Now, of course, if you see in INR, the cost is huge. But then, of course, the package is also huge, which you come out with when they, you know, when you graduate from there. So don't get your mind blown away with the number of the this thing fees. But also do your research that, okay, so this is the kind of fees I'm putting in, and this will be the output. This will be the kind of package I'll be placed with after that. Plus, I get to experience the culture that is there outside. And if I'm someone who loves exploring new things, I think it would be a great opportunity for me. But again, to get into these kind of institutes, it's very important that you put in a lot of hard work and effort, because in the first place, it's not easy to get there. अभी आप फीस दे के पीछे मत हटो, आप मेहनत तो करो. See, if you can reach there, if you really put in all the effort that you have, you will be able to reach there. Yes, now coming to best paying MBA institutes all over the world. So, of course, the top 11, if we see, they are the US colleges, MIT, Harvard Business School, University of Chicago, University of Pennsylvania, Columbia Business School, New York University, Cornell, Duke, Northwestern, Michigan, Anderson, and yes, INSEAD is a very good university in France. So, if you talk about the packages that they offer, these are the institutes that offer the best compensation plans once you become graduate out of there. So, yes, keep this in mind. You can screenshot this slide as well. Coming to the next slide of today, whether to go for an MBA or not. Now you decide. I have given you what kind of factors you should consider, what are the costs that will be involved, how much time and effort you'll have to put, whether you should have work experience or not. Everything I've shared with you. And of course, this was what I think, yes, we have done here. So, yes, talking about what kind of institutes you should target, what factors you should consider, I've covered it in every possible detail with you. Now, before we wrap up and before we get to the conclusion, like I already shared with you, we have a very special session coming up today, which would be alternatives to MBA. And it will be taken by Mr. Dhaval Parvatikar. Now, Dhaval, if you're here, can you please come and say hi to everyone? So we have a brief...
Hi, everyone. It was a great session.
I think you're on mute. Online. Let me just spotlight you.
Sorry. Can you hear me?
I can't hear you. Can everybody else hear?
I've unmuted myself.
He's audible. Yes. Okay. Only I can hear him.
Yes.
Everybody can hear me.
Okay. Now I can hear, yes.
Great session, Bhavna. I think a lot of in-depth information you have covered in this session, and I'm sure the participants will be definitely think about these questions which you shared and what's right for them, right? And it takes some time to figure out as well. It takes some time to figure out as to what is your liking and what are your interests, and then decide accordingly. Right. And so I would also advise that don't be in a hurry to decide right now. Like many of us are, the moment we complete our CA, we kind of get nervous as to, you know, what's next. I need to do something. Others are doing something, you know, and so I need to do something now. I need to do CFA, I need to do MBA, I need to do something right now. But it's okay. I mean, if you take probably a couple of years also to figure out what is your interest and then plan your further qualification, it's completely okay. Just don't be in a hurry, research well. That would be my advice. And our session is tomorrow, right? For alternate.
Yes, our session is tomorrow at 6 p.m.
Right.
You can give a brief about that if you want.
So I think these are some of the common questions which all of us, when we clear our chartered accountancy, and I had the same questions 10 years ago when I cleared my chartered accountancy, that, you know, whether to do MBA, should I go to Canada, should I do CIMA, should I do CFA, you know, sometimes I felt like doing MBA, sometimes I felt like doing a business, sometimes I felt like, starting my own CA coaching. So I think we have all been there, right? And these things are... the very common questions which come to every chartered accountant's mind, right? But it takes time to figure out. And tomorrow we'll cover some interesting elements as to what are the alternatives for MBA, or rather, what I would suggest is that tomorrow we'll cover on some topics as to why you really need an MBA. Like, for example, if it's a business management role that you want to try, why not try it with your chartered accountancy?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And there are pretty much options available where we can try these courses, roles as well. And also, we'll look at some certification options for management, and also some blended learning courses are a very important element these days, where you spend some days on campus and the rest you do through live online lectures by professors from IIM or any of these top institutes. Right, even foreign institutes as well. Right? So we'll look at some options tomorrow and figure out as to what are the options that you can do along with your job. Right. And to some extent, to be very honest, I was never a fan of putting my job and investing 50 lakhs off. Because it also comes with an opportunity cost, right? Because your salary is 10 lakhs, and if you're quitting for 2 years and then joining MBA, which means effectively your 20 lakhs of fees plus your 20-25 lakhs of salary forgone will actually make it a 50 lakh course when you include the opportunity cost. So I was
exactly
a big fan of that. So I always try to find some or the other hack to it and see what, apart from, you know, what can I do and upgrade myself without quitting my job, without losing out on my experience. Because the experience I was getting was also good. Right? I didn't want to leave that, and make sure that that's a combination of experience and upgrading myself. So there is a balance in that as well. Right? I was never a big fan of quitting everything and then go after that full-time MBA of 2 years. So we look at some options tomorrow and great session. I'm completely for doing MBA. Not that, you know, if you have a chance, if your family is supportive, if you are financially sound, and if your family can support you with that, and if you have that right attitude to crack into those top institutes, definitely go for it. Right? Definitely go for it. That would be the number one preference. But if you can't, or somehow if you're unsure of you, or if you don't want to, then maybe tomorrow's session will be for you.
Right. I think you, yes, you actually gave a food for thought to everyone that, okay, you know, opportunity cost, you also have to consider when you're leaving your job and going for a full-time course like that. Definitely a very good point to consider. So yes, I think tomorrow's session will be full of insights. Yes.
Right. Yeah, one of my friends spent about 70 lakhs and did some MBA from Boston University. And, you know, I was always telling that if I had 70 lakhs, I would have started my own business. So, other alternatives as well. Definitely.
Yeah, that's true. Okay. So, yes, if you are still, we've already had our sessions on, you know, ACCA, CPA, CFA and MBA. Now, coming to MBA, if you are still perplexed on, you know, whether to go for it or not, or what you should opt for, then yes, tomorrow's session is definitely for you. And we'll have it at 6 p.m. same time. We'll be sharing the meeting link in the same group. And I'm sure like it will be a very insightful session for all of us. Thank you so much, Dhaval, for sharing your opinion and insights about today's session. And we look forward to listening to you in tomorrow's session. Thank you, everyone, for joining. I'll hopefully see you all tomorrow at 6. And yes, thanks a lot. Okay, bye-bye, everyone, and good night.
How are you doing?
Thank you, Bhavna. Bye.